In today's video, we are going to be talking about autophagy and 5 ways to increase it with and without fasting. The word autophagy is derived from the Greek words auto, which means self, and phagein, which means to eat. Basically, it means self-eating, and that's what autophagy is. It is a cellular process where your body cleans out damaged cells and regenerates new ones. Autophagy is a good thing. You can think of it like this. The cells in your body are not meant to last forever, just like parts in your car. At some point, they will become worn down and need to be replaced. If your car gets a flat tire, you will want to replace it. Your car is not going to work very well if you are driving around and ignore the flat. And the same goes for your cells. If one becomes damaged, you want it to be replaced. And that is where autophagy comes in. Now, autophagy is always happening when we sleep to some degree, but there are some additional steps you can take to increase it. So in today's video, I'm going to give you 5 things you can do to boost autophagy. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name's Kate. I'm a health coach and I post videos on a high fat, nutrient dense way of eating. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, feel free to share, and make sure to subscribe. And make sure to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook where I share new posts every single day. As I mentioned at the start, autophagy is a really interesting mechanism, but our understanding of it is relatively new. Researchers have known about autophagy since the 1960s, but it has only been within the last decade that it has become a topic of particular interest. The 2016 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine was awarded to Yoshinori Osumai for his discoveries of mechanisms for autophagy. Osumai's work illustrates the importance of autophagy for our cells and their need to be degraded and recycled. But autophagy is not just about optimizing health. It can also be used to prevent and even reverse disease. As is the case with Parkinson's and Alzheimer's, for example, autophagy removes toxic proteins from the cells that are attributed to these neurodegenerative diseases. In general, autophagy decreases as we age. So this means that the amount of damaged cells can increase. And this might be part of the reason for other diseases that are associated with aging. Autophagy has also been shown to reduce inflammation, fight infection, and increase longevity. Everyone has the ability to increase autophagy, no matter your age. So now let's get into the ways you can do this. And make sure to stick around until the end because tip number 4 might surprise you. Number 1, intermittent fasting. Fasting is by far the number 1 way to increase autophagy. It isn't fully understood why autophagy increases when we are fasting, but what is known is that when insulin is low and glucagon is high, the glucagon triggers it. So when I say intermittent fasting, I am referring to not eating for a period of time every day. Usually this is anywhere from 16 to 22 hours. Someone practicing intermittent fasting will not eat for this period of time and then will eat all of their calories for the day within a smaller time frame. Although it is impossible to measure autophagy outside of a lab, most researchers agree that the process begins between 16 and 20 hours after your last meal. Number 2, exercise. Both aerobic exercise and high-intensity interval training have been shown to trigger autophagy. Aerobic exercise is basically cardio, anything that is low impact and that you can sustain for long periods of time. Think walking, jogging, or cycling. But high-intensity interval training, also known as HIIT, can give you more bang for your buck. This type of training involves sprinting for short periods of time, resting for short periods of time, and repeating. Generally, you only have to do this for 10 to 20 minutes at a time, and you get a lot of the same benefits as aerobic exercise, including autophagy. Now, what I really want to stress with HIIT is that you don't want to be doing this every day. You probably don't even want to be doing it more than once a week. You will get the most benefit from doing HIIT workouts once a week and doing it on a day where you are fully recovered and can give it your all. Number 3, eat a ketogenic diet. The keto diet is a way of eating that is low in carbs and high in fat, and it is well known to mimic a lot of the benefits of fasting. One of these benefits is that it keeps insulin low, because you are limiting foods that have the greatest insulin response. Now, I've been talking a lot on my channel lately about insulin and insulin resistance, but for anyone who isn't familiar, insulin is a hormone, sometimes referred to as the fat storage hormone. When we eat, insulin increases, and glucagon, which is the counter hormone, decreases. Insulin is released to help shuttle the excess energy in your bloodstream to your cells. And that is how it gets the nickname of the fat storage hormone. When insulin is high, your body is storing fat. Glucagon is triggered in the opposite way. When you haven't eaten for a while, glucagon increases, and it triggers your body to release stored energy. Glucagon is also the trigger for autophagy, which I briefly mentioned earlier. Carbohydrates are the macronutrient that triggers insulin the most, and in turn suppresses glucagon. Insulin pretty much stops autophagy dead in its tracks. So anytime you eat a high carb meal, you are stopping autophagy. Now, if you eat a low carb diet, such as the keto diet, the food you are eating has a much less significant impact on insulin. So your insulin stays low, glucagon stays higher, and autophagy is activated more regularly. I do have a lot of other videos on my channel about how to eat a keto diet, the best foods to eat, the worst foods to eat, so I will link one of those videos above and you can check it out afterwards. Number four, get quality sleep. Autophagy also increases when we sleep. Of course, when you are sleeping, you're not eating and technically fasting, so this makes sense. But the quality of your sleep also matters. One study done on mice found that when sleep was fragmented, so there were interruptions in the sleep, autophagy was disrupted. My absolute number one tip for improving sleep quality is to invest in a pair of blue light blocking glasses. Blue light has been shown to suppress melatonin and disrupt our sleep. Basically, blue light is a really big factor in syncing our circadian rhythm. During the day, blue light is emitted from the sun, and it boosts our alertness. And in the evening, when the sun sets, this signals our bodies that it is almost time for bed, and melatonin is released. The problem is that our modern environments are filled with blue light. Our phones, our computer screens, our lights, we are staring into blue light well after sunset, and this messes with our circadian rhythm. And this is where blue light blockers come in. Glasses like these ones from Blue Blocks block 100% of blue light, so you can pop them on after sunset and sleep like a baby. Now, the reason I like Blue Blocks over other brands is that they actually live up to their claims. A lot of other brands on the market do not even block blue light, or do not block it 100%. So if you are using blue light blockers, you really want to make sure you're getting what you paid for. I do have a discount code for Blue Blocks if you want to try them out. I will link these glasses in the description box down below, and you can use the code HCK15 to save 15% off your order. Number five, extended fasting. And the final way to boost autophagy is by extended fasting. Generally, an extended fast is anything more than 24 hours. As I mentioned earlier, when we spoke about intermittent fasting, autophagy begins 16 to 20 hours after we last ate, but it reaches its peak somewhere between 48 to 72 hours. Now, the thing with extended fasting is that it does not have to be done regularly. A 48-hour fast every 3 months or a 72-hour fast every 6 months is enough to reap the benefits. Extended fasting too often will cause more harm than good. And those are five ways you can increase autophagy. Obviously, some of these tips you can implement daily, and other ones only need to be implemented periodically. Now, I know you're probably thinking, what can you consume during a fast that won't stop autophagy? A general rule of thumb is that any food you eat will stop autophagy, and any drinks with calories will stop autophagy. Water is okay to drink, black coffee probably okay, and unsweetened tea. But beyond that, if your goal is autophagy, I wouldn't consume anything else during your fasting window. Anyways, guys, that is all I have for you today. Let me know in the comment section down below if you practice intermittent or extended fasting for the purpose of autophagy. If you did enjoy this video, giving it a thumbs up and leaving me a comment, show YouTube that you enjoyed it and help the video to reach more people. Thank you guys for watching, and if you did enjoy this video, you might also like my video on 7 drinks that do not break a fast. You can check it out here. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, you can find it here. And if you want to check out my keto diet and carnivore diet coaching programs, you can find them here. Thanks again, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.